whatever you do, do it to the absolute best of your ability. Because not only are we all personally strengthened through your service, but our communities, our county, and our country are strengthened by our mere presence, by our commitment, and our collective work. Your service is our strength. Thank you so much, and may God bless each of you.
Over 5 years ago, when the doctors told me I had 1 year to live, I thought that God was playing a cruel and unusual joke on me. But then I realized I can take my ordeal and turn it into an opportunity to witness to those about God's wonderful mercy and his amazing grace.
So, I'm concerned about the future of our young women. I'm concerned about each of you seated in this room, because if we don't stand together and stand tall, I don't know what kind of laws, rules, policies, or regulations will come out of Washington, D.C. And I would tell you that an empowered woman knows who she is. She knows herself, and she understands her strengths and her weaknesses. She knows what she wants, she sets goals, and she knows how to reach them.
That the days we live in are not our better days, that our better days are in front of us. We have to grab it. We have to be bold. We have to be brave.
Because as we continue to live life, there's a possibility that someone may become disabled. So my goal is to ensure that the county is accessible so we all can live very independent lives. And it is hoped that there will be some new advocates who will come behind me after my journey's over. Thank you so much.
There was one question that I kept getting a lot, and since I work for NASA, a lot of kids ask me, do you want to go in space? And the first time I got the question, I said, no, I'm too old. And this 8-year-old yelled at me. She's way down. She points her finger at me and she says, what? You can do anything you want to do. And after that, my answer was yes.
I am great and you are great. Ladies, on the count of three, say I am great. 1, 2, 3. I learned that from a very great lady herself. That is Pastor Peggy Macklin of the Sanctuary Church, who's here today. She inspired me not to feel good about myself on days when you feel down, ladies, and you need to pick yourself up. Or if you've done something great and you feel good about it, and yet some may not feel that great about you on some days, you simply look at the mirror and say to yourself, I am great.
I heard Prince George's County loves to have fun. Come on. Sing it. Come on, stand up with me. I'm every woman. This is about us today, ladies. Tell somebody at the table, I am every woman. It's all in me. Because we just made the affirmation, we just made a declaration that I am every woman. I may have been made from Adam's rib, but I have backbone. I have a brilliant mind. I even have eyes in the back of my head. I've got strong shoulders. I have a heart of compassion, and I have hands that know how to pray. I have broken the glass ceiling with my high heels to excel in non-traditional careers such as a newscaster, a school principal, a doctor, an engineer, a business owner, an author, a college president, a judge, a firefighter, and even a motivational speaker. I am every woman. I am the First Lady of the United States of America. There is a hot comb in the White House. Trust and believe. Don't let anything or anyone stop you from shining. Don't let anyone or anything stop you from believing that you can do and be and have the desires of your heart. Be unstoppable and be every woman. God bless you.